Welcome back, everybody, to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, Episode 8. We are going to start our adventures today in all of the Colossus Boulevard, take down the Gobbler King, but first we have to destroy 3 evil snowmen and 5 gobblers, and after I do that, I'll see you guys then. Alrighty, everybody, welcome back. I have destroyed all, well, not all, but 3 snowmen and 5 of the gobblers. And let's listen to what Mindy has to have us do next.
Well, that didn't seem to make a dent in those gobblers at all. They're still eating the city. Go speak with Professor Greyrose. Maybe she will know what to do. I'll try to keep their damage to a minimum.
Greyrose. All right, let's leave a mark here. Go to the commons and then see what she has to say. I was reading the comments once again, like I always do. And I was asking you guys of what schools I should train into, and you all were saying, which I kind of thought made sense to me as well, was, excuse me, the Ice School for Tower Shield, of course, Death up to Faint, and then Life up to Satyr. So I think that's the direction we have to take. The first thing I think we should do is into ice or death. I'll have to make up my mind, but that's kind of what I am structuring it around.
Oh dear, I was afraid of that. It was an accident. I didn't mean to summon those gobblers, and those evil snowmen aren't doing a thing to help. They're actually causing more trouble.
You did this, Grey Rose?
The biggest problem with gobblers is that they're always hungry. Let's try brewing a potion to make them lose their appetite. The snowmen, we'll deal with later.
Always cheeky, aren't you, Grey Rose?
Here is a list of ingredients for the potion. Take it back to Minty Pixie Crown on Colossus Boulevard.
She probably did brew it inside that thing. So, let us look. To get to Tower Shield, we need 5 training points. So, you know, I think that's the exact same way for Faint. Let's go check. I believe the Death student over here can have you train up to Faint, or either that's Dworgen. Let's just make sure. I don't know. Nope. Excuse me. It does not. So, I'm trying to remember. Is Dworgen or someplace else where you get it? Let's equip a mount. That'll be easier, huh? Also, level 12, I have another myth quest from Sirius, and then also I need to remember I need to go get my myth shield from Sabrina Greenstar. This is also something for you all to know, which I was happily reminded by, and thank you for all those who have been helping me, that Sabrina... Level 10, excuse me, myth shield, minus 80, so that's for free. And then the other ones cost a point, of course, but we're going to be saving up our points, and we will be training into the school. I think we should start training into a school before we head to Croc, but I don't think any other time sooner than that. I don't know. There's really no need. Also, I do have the Myth Prism, so if I do go against Myth, I'll use that. But let's see what Minnie has to say about these potions.
A magic potion? Excellent idea! I'll begin working on this list she gave us. I'll set up the cauldron for the potion here. Can you get the first ingredient? It's called Stinkweed. You can find that growing right here in Colossus
Stinkweed.
Boulevard.
Isn't that the plant that dislikes everything? Where the heck is the stinkweed? Oh, yeah, I think it's on the roads. Is it the depressed asparagus? Either one. I mean, they both have terrible names, but... let's try and find the stinkweed. Let's just confirm it. I'm pretty sure... it's over here. If not, it might be on the other side. I can't remember. It's a toss-up. Oh, yep. Okay, so it's... oh, that's dangerous. There's Briskbreeze Tower. My gosh, the memories, I tell you. Here it is. Here's the first one. So anyway, let us try and find the rest of them. Alrighty, this is the last one, and I traveled all the way towards the castle for the majority of them. There's three of them over here, and then there's a few across the roads, but I recommend going towards there because there's a lot of them. It's quite the journey, but it's definitely worth it. Rank 2 elites over here, the munchers and whatnot. Okay, so we're gonna collect the stink weed for the potion. I think we have to fight a boss soon. I could be wrong, but from what I remember, we might have to. I think he's like, well, he's a gobbler, I know that, but I think he's like, I think he has like food everywhere. It's kind of funny. She left the port over by Mindy, but you know what? It's okay. I actually like how they're on the houses. They're just, they're just sitting there. Oh, okay. The evil snowmen, when you have to face them, they have about 300 health or so. I also, for point of reference, and also a little bit of helping, I bought some, or got some monstrous cards from Nate. He had a surplus of them, and he was just talking about it. These TCs, if you have another character, highly recommend getting them from the bazaar. If you have gold, definitely worth it. If you're just starting out, well, you know what? You can get by without monstrous. I could as well, which I mostly will sometimes, but just for the heck of it, I will use them to make my life easier and to make the battles go a little bit faster and, you know, with the one hit. So I highly recommend that and, you know, just make your life easier.
Woo! This stinkweed really does stink. I know I've lost my appetite. That's all I need. I'll brew the potion now.
Where's your cauldron?
Here's the first batch of potion, young wizard. Hopefully this will make the gobblers stop eating. While I'm making more, go beat some gobblers in combat and make them drink the stinkweed potion.
Okay, so I am going to defeat any gobbler for a gobbler. I think let's go defeat him over here. Let's try and get two gobblers in one battle. We don't want to fight any snowmen if we don't have to. So after I defeat four of the gobblers, let me just destroy these guys over here. I'll see you guys then, and then I think it's boss time. I think we have to go over there. So I'll see you guys when I fight them all. Alrighty, welcome back everybody. We defeated the four gobblers, and hopefully Mindy is brewing that potion. I didn't have to give him the potion though. So hopefully magically they drank the potion, of course. They magically drank it. But let's see if she's finally done with her brewery.
All done? Excellent. Let's see if the potion had any effect. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say the potion didn't quite work. I don't want to bother the headmaster.
Yeah, he doesn't want to be bothered with his ointment making skills in that closet.
I know. The Gobbler King lives in the large palace at the very end of the street. Maybe we can reason with him. I'll try to brew a stronger potion. See if you can make a deal with the Gobbler King to stop eating and leave the city.
Okay, let's leave a mark here. Some more things I wanted to talk about. I'll take the opportunity now, you know, because we have to walk all the way to the Gobbler King. So basically, after Colossus Boulevard, I plan to do the Crab Alley, as I said previously many times, and I am committed to doing that, along with the level 12 myth quest. I was wondering if you all wanted me to do the quest for the Smiths. So, basically what I'm trying to say is, do you want me to do that for every world? Find all of the little people or the objects or what have you to get that extra training point to help out. So that's up in the air. That's something to think about. Most people won't want me to. Some, a lot of people will want me to, and I think that I should. It's going to be a video where I will be doing a lot of cuts. So basically, as you can see, that one over there, the Smith, you know, I go to each place like Triton Avenue, Cost Boulevard, and do a few cuts here and there. Something to think about. Definitely something to think about. But, because when it comes down to it, it will be a little bit of a struggle to do that in higher up worlds. but I think it'll be worth it.
You'll have to get past me if you want to see the king.
Okay. Oh, is this... Are we seriously already almost done? Are we seriously... No way! I swear this place takes longer. Did they shorten this area? I'm shaking my head. Huh, no way. There has to be something after this. I mean, I think, but I don't know. Maybe there's just side quests that we have to do. I don't know. Yep, we got the TCs. We already got them. I'm kind of in shock, really. How much health does he have? Ooh, you know what we should do? We should kill the Gobbler Gorger, definitely. Let's summon a minion. And then we'll monstrous a Cyclops. Okay, did he just throw up? Look at his feet! Oh! The feet! Oh my gosh! I am so done. I have no words. That is...
Guys.
Of course. Okay. Yeah. To make things even better there. Never really... Oh my gosh. The prince, right? Yeah. He's dead. That's basically the way that goes. I love how he has a little chicken thing.
Oh my gosh.
I actually love the Colossus Boulevard for this reason. But I'm actually surprised, though, that we're done. I mean, kind of. I mean, I don't know. We'll have to figure out after this. Oh, that did mass. Because I normally thought we had to, like, at least face one other boss, who I think was, like, a red gobbler who's, like, small but still fat. I don't know. We'll have to see. Hey, what the heck? I'm wasting them, but that's what they're here for. And I highly recommend using them. It'll make your life a lot easier if you don't have the luxury of able to buy them. I would suggest... I don't know. I would have to say you can get by without them, like I said previously. But, and I feel like you need them, in a way, for certain times. Especially when we get Frog, and that's going to be the... Oh, what the heck is this? And it'll become very important to have that little extra oomph in those battles with the Humunga Frog. Because, you know, it's basically does like 200 to 300 or something like that. He just ate that building. He's a beast. He's a beast.
A tiny wizard. Hello, tiny wizard. Have you come to surrender your city? You want us to leave? Oh no. No, no, no! My people love it here. We shall call this city New Gobbleton. If you prove to be good servants, perhaps we shall let the tiny wizard stay in New Gobbleton. Here is my royal decree.
Whoever did the voice acting for this, I applaud you.
You pick up the royal decree to take back to Mindy Pixie Crown.
Okay, let's go back to Mindy. Was she... Yeah, okay, let's port back. Oh my gosh, he's a mega beast! There she is. Let's see what we have to do.
The Gobbler King wants us to surrender Wizard City? Big problem. Big problem.
We leveled up!
The Gobblers are trying to claim Wizard City. We need to tell Headmaster Ambrose.
We leveled up.
Take the Gobbler King's royal decree to Headmaster Ambrose. See what he thinks we should do.
He's probably going to tell us to slap him good. That's probably where the ointment comes into play. Oh, gosh. I don't know. I think there's still some stuff to do. But then again, could be wrong. As always, I'm still fuzzy with what we need to do, but...
What? This decree doesn't even make sense. It's just people and chickens drawn in crayon.
Headmaster Ambrose shakes his head
sadly. He's shaking my head!
The gobblers may be a larger problem than we realized. I hate to ask, but you need to go duel some of them to test their strength.
Oh. Gobbler Gorger. Okay, let's go. Oh, those are the guys just right in front of the area. The leaf, or the leaf. The life guys. The leaves. Oh, I tell ya. It hasn't been that hard, though, the boulevard so far. I mean, normally it's kind of more intimidating because, I mean, I don't know, it seems it's a little bit bigger and there's, like, more stuff to do, but not really. There really isn't that much extra stuff to do. So let me face these guys, and I'll see you guys when I get it done. Okay, so we defeated the two gobblers. Oh, we gotta go kill two scouters now. It's basically every type of species of gobbler, I assume. I think that's the way it rolls. Not too bad. But we did get level 11, so that is really awesome. So I'm gonna face these two gobbler scouters, and after I defeat them, I'll see you guys then. Alrighty, so this is the last scouter that we have to face. I'm assuming we have to face the two elites. Yep. That is the way the cookie crumbles. Rank 2 elite. Yep. So, after I defeat the two elites, I'll see you guys then. Alright. The munchers now. Which are... Oh, we got even... Okay, I should have looked at that before. So we got two more types of gobblers. I am going to defeat the munchers, and after that, I'll see you guys again. Okay, and down go the munchers. Last one to defeat, gluttons. So that will be that. I believe Meryl, like, creates something or says something, and then the megabath, I forgot what he does. Or he, like... I forgot. It's something to do with food. So anyway, I'm gonna defeat these guys, and then we'll see what Meryl needs. Okay, so a thing to note from the gluttons, they have 395 health, so be careful when you go in there. Make sure you have some heals. Because that will get antsy if you don't. Let me tell you.
Good. Now that we know how strong the gobblers are, I have a plan. Please deliver this letter to Mindy Pixie Crown for me. Your hard work will pay off, I promise.
Headmaster Ambrose hands you an official-looking document.
Oh, easy, Meryl. Always trying to slide in those quests. Mindy!
Mindy Pixie Crown reads the official-looking document.
I think this plan will work. This plan calls for challenging the Gobbler King's two closest advisors.
Okay, this makes
Baron
sense
Gravely
now.
Baron Gravely and Baron Rotunda. Dueling isn't my strength, so you're the only one who can do this, young wizard. They're each hiding out in towers, one at each end of the street. Defeat them and see what the Gobbler King has to say then.
Okay, so I will... make my way over to Baron Greebly, and when I make over to his castle, I will see you guys then, and then after Greebly, we'll fight Rotunda, and then finish things up on Colossus Boulevard, so I'll see you guys when I get over there. I apologize for cutting so early. I would have normally walked up to Greebly, but something came up, so I am back now, finishing the boulevard, so sorry for that. I would have normally walked a few feet, but... you know how it goes.
Is it time for dinner yet? You look like you'd make a good stew. Get over here.
So, the most powerful mob we faced so far was the glutton, which had almost 400 health. That's actually a lot, so watch out for that, definitely. Let's summon a minion. And I ran out of the monstrous TCs, and it was a little bit of a struggle if you don't have those, definitely. So we have to face Greebly, and we have to face Rotunda, I think was his name, or something like that. Here we go. And he should be dead. And then after that, I think Meryl, like, comes up with something, and then I think the beast eats, like, a meal or something. I don't know. I can't remember. Oh my, that's disgusting. That's outright foul. You should be ashamed of yourself, Greebly. He is a chicken drumstick as well. So, I cannot wait till level 12. Thanks, puppet. Alright, at least he's dead. Let us monstrous a Cyclops. And let's hit Greebly. And then one more hit, and then Greebly will be dead. And then we'll make our way over to the other boss, which won't be that bad. I think, there's a guy next to the Brisk Breeze Tower, who I believe has some side quests, which I think you just have to defeat some things and collect for him and to create something from what used to do a lot. There we go. And I don't even know if that's really worth it for the extra little boost since we're doing the Crab Alley. We'll have to see. But I kept thinking about it since I had to go away for a little bit. And then now I'm here. Once again, he's dead. I hope. Yeah, I'm dead. All right. So for collecting the smiths and whatnot, I believe I'm going to be doing that. That will be... I think I'm going to start kind of the rotation for those videos at the end. Completely at the end of the world, right before about to wrap things up. And I'll just, like, you know, kind of, in a way, shove that to the very end. So you can look forward to that, and then we'll move on to the next world. Alright, let's... Ooh, are those better? No, they're not better. The Troll King. That actually sounds really cool. Alright, we need to find a Health Wisp. Or we're gonna be in trouble. Oh! See, I didn't get it. I was not gonna push that. I was not. So yeah, I've been thinking about it a little more. And I think it's the best thing to do. I mean, since it is a full game walkthrough, whatever I can do to help you all out, my little tips that I've learned over my years. Excuse me. Just, you know, those little nudges of help always make the difference. Oh yeah, and Kazool has Quest, the Iron Helm guy, which I think he just has more collect quests if I'm wrong. Something like that. Which we don't need to do. So this guy's 500 away, huh? Oh yeah, that's the purple guy I was thinking about. I knew there was a purple guy somewhere. Couldn't remember exactly where, but at least I'm not going crazy. He's not over here, but let's get that Health Wisp. And can we make it? We made it. Look at the map again. Yep, Brisk Breeze Tower. Oh my gosh, it doesn't look that bad. Oh, there we go. That is pretty bad. It is. Bum 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 bum. You can always see Bartleby no matter where you are. Yeah, those gluttons, they actually are a little bit of a pain, so. Rotunda Chaluhu? Is that what this place is called? Something like that. And I think this is his brother or something, so let's see what this guy say. Are we gonna become a stew as well?
You've come to take away my treats? I can't allow that. To battle!
Okay, so he does have a glutton. This is gonna be a little bit of a struggle, but a little bit easier since I'll have monstrous TC, so let's go in and destroy Rotunda. The thing that gets me is the feet, I swear. Alright, we don't need that. I think we should summon our minion. Yeah, I think we should. Because I used my 35 and the 25, and then I Cyclops, and it still didn't kill one of the Galtons without Monstrous, so it goes to show how powerful they are. I mean, I almost killed them, but, you know. Alright, let's use this on that, and then hopefully I can find a Cyclops. Use Cyclops with Monstrous, and he's dead. And then we'll focus on Rotunda. He's pretty round. Troll. I think the most powerful spell so far used on me was Cyclops. I think, anyway. My memory is fading me. Kind of. Double troll! Come on, Minotaur! Plus! No. Nope. There we go. Now he's dead. Okay, I was gonna say. Unless I fizzle. Oh, he's mad. He's not having it. Most damage you've ever done right there. There we are. Perfect, perfect. And I will go through these monsters' TCs pretty fast, I have a feeling. So I gotta be careful of how I use them. Ooh, well, hey, what the heck. Eh, he's dead. Fizz, yeah. Never mind. Too ambitious, huh? Can't get too ambitious, but I did. And I failed. Kind of. Not really, though. Draw? I guess we'll have two troll enchant things. Well, one in reserve. Unless I fizz again. Nope. You dead rotund. Do the gobbler. Oh, yeah, we gotta talk to him. Okay. Hey, we got Gobbler Chaser. That's pretty cool. I still like the Protector title. Alright! Some people just stare at walls. I have nothing against that. Sometimes you just gotta think. I really do like this castle. One of the coolest buildings, I think, in all of Wizard City, really. It really is. Also, another thing, I never understood why they didn't put the gobbler thing over the other archways of the ice. I don't know. I guess they got too lazy. Talk to Gobbler King. Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, we have to face him. Oh, yeah, that's right. We have to face him again. So we have to face him more than once. I guess that's a thing. We will have to heal then. So let us do that, and we'll pixie. Or fairy, anyway. Just to make sure. I forgot that you have to face him again. I would have got a health wisp, but we're still good. Just could take a little longer. Not too bad, though. There we go. I'm gonna fairy, summon a minion. Hopefully we can find that minion next time. Alright, that's pixie. Well, I mean, it's basically fairy, but it's called pixie. I don't know. And then sprite's called sprite. Which makes sense! So, you know. Heal up real quick. Minion, and then we'll start things fresh. Perfect. There we are. And this will be easier as well. Bum, 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 bum. That was my chair. If you heard that or not. Alright, let us discard that. Cyclops that. Draw that. Troll. Using that on that. What the heck? Let's kill the Gorger. Rub the belly. Cast the spell. Nice! Things are coming on our way. And I was also reading a comment before, myth official colors are blue and yellow. Is that true? I don't know. That is perfect beyond anything. That is awesome, since I am blue and I don't know if that's the way that is. That's going to be really exciting. All right, let's remove these since that won't really help that much. Use that on that. Myth trap. And then we'll keep passing and then we'll use troll. At least it wasn't lightning bats. Because if that's the, nice. Myth colors, that's like perfect beyond measure. I think eventually I won't have the Guardian's armor for my myth, like my death, because that's the kind of look I've had on my death for quite some time, so I'll have to eventually, long down the road, have to figure out a new kind of style for my myth. I want it to be unique, just like my death guy is. Alright, so this guy is dead. Definitely. For sure. Rip. For sure. Tried to kill me, but it's not gonna work. Perfect, perfect. And I don't know, I kinda like the look of... I mean, I don't like the way the hat looks perfectly the way I have this one, but I like that... I don't know, kinda like the way Lewis has his, but then again... We'll have to see. It's gonna have to be unique. Alright, he's dead. Let's just kill, just make sure. I do want a cape. I don't really have like a flowing cape on my death guy. Yeah, kind of a small cape, not really a true cape. I feel like Myth needs a cape of some sort. And the prince goes down again. What was that sound? People burping? Alright, let's talk to the beast again.
Ah, the little wizard is back. Are you ready to surrender now?
You tell the Gobbler King about your battles with Barons Greebly and Rotunda.
What? You defeated them?
Mm-hmm.
I find that hard to believe. I'll have to send someone to find out if what you say is true or not.
Just as the Gobbler King is getting ready to call, a messenger breaks into the room.
Sir, the two barons have been defeated by a student wizard. What shall we do?
Oh dear. What you said is true. Then that means no Gobbler King...
Was that easy, huh?
Wizard City is yours. Spare me and my people, wizard. We mean you no harm. I ask that we are allowed to stay here. Our old home was filled with witches, and we are too scared to go back. I promise we will not eat so much. You have my word.
And it's as simple as that, huh? Talk to the Gobbler King. Defeat a few people. Alright, so I'm going to cut to when I get to Mindy, because it is quite the journey. When I get to her, I'll see you guys then. Alright, I made my way back to Mindy. And I think we're wrapping things up in Colossus Boulevard.
Amazing, young wizard. You have brought peace with the gobblers. You've done a great job. Be sure to tell Headmaster Ambrose what the Gobbler King said. Now I can get back to my project.
Well, that is the Colossus Boulevard entirety. I like the Colossus Boulevard. It's... I like how kind of not far away it is from the other streets, but it's its own unique area. I mean, everything has its own unique area, but I feel like the Colossus Boulevard is a little bit of a notch above. And, you know, I mean, I think it's really cool. And the beast definitely makes it.
My plan worked. Oh, that's excellent news.
You tell Headmaster Ambrose what the Gobbler King said about their home world.
My, my. I certainly don't want to force them to go back to a world where they aren't welcome.
Yep.
Very well. We will let them stay on Colossus Boulevard. It appears we have new neighbors.
Oh, we don't want that one. All right, do we want that one? How does that one look? Does it have the same look of the other ones? Oh my gosh, we are definitely using this one. Are you kidding me? Thing's amazing. Alright, so that will do it for me today. Leave a like if you've enjoyed the video. next time we will be traveling to Crab Alley. I feel like I need to do a few more side quests to get to level 12. But let me just go make sure before we end the video. Let's go head over to Triton Avenue. Because I don't know for sure if you have to be level 12. I didn't see any comments saying that you have to be level 12. I just want to make sure. If you do, then I will do a couple of side quests, you know, somewhere for fun. Well, maybe not for fun, but to get the job done so that we can face, you know... Oh, excuse me, the Crab Alley. And the Crab Alley, for people who don't know, it's down in this, like, little water area. And it's a little bit harder. It's, like, one of the most, like... powerful streets of, like, Wizard. Okay, so let's see if we can go down into here. Can we? Nope, we cannot. So, I'm going to be doing some side quests, investigate a little more of what I have to do to get down here, and then we have to do Sunken City, and discover where all of the smiths are, and that will be the entire world of Wizard City. So, just a few more episodes, and we'll be done with Wizard City, moving on to Croc. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Have a good day, and I'll see you guys next time.